Good evening, everyone. How have you been?
Very good.
I'm fine, thank you. Okay, everyone, today we will study something about flyers, right? And today we will start with reading and writing skills. First of all, I want to introduce you some words that will appear in our lesson today, okay? The first one, this animal lives in the sea. It has 8 legs. Can you guess what it is? Okay, I bet that you know the answer, right? And I will show it right now. This animal is an octopus, right? Okay, it has 8 legs and it lives in the sea. Okay, now let's move to the next one. You use this to cut food. It is usually made of metal. What is it? Okay. Now, let's know the answer. Oh, what is it? Yeah, it's a knife. Okay, remember that. It's a knife, okay? Now, listen and repeat one more time. A knife. Good job. The next one. You use this book to find out what words mean. Okay. So if you don't know the new words, you can look up in this book and you will know what it is. So what is it? Yeah, a dictionary. Okay, now listen and repeat one more time. A dictionary. Good job. Okay. Now let's move to the next one. A doctor might tell you to take this if you are ill. Okay, if you are get sick, what do you use? Okay, to recover from the sickness. Yeah, of course, it's medicine. Okay, listen and repeat one more time. Medicine. Okay, medicine. Good job. Now, the next one. You put this on a letter before you send it. So, what is it? You put this one on a letter before you send it. So, if you don't have this one, you cannot send it. It's very important. So, what is it? Yeah, a stamp. Okay, now listen and repeat one more time. A stamp. Good job. Okay, after introducing some new words, and I want to show you the pass on with 10 questions, okay? Look and read. Choose the correct words and write them on the lines. That is one example. Okay. These are all the words in this part. And it is the definition. Example, you use this to wash your body. Now look at all the words in the box. Okay? The first one is an octopus, right? An umbrella, a knife, a dentist, a stamp, a teacher, butter, a snowman, soap, an astronaut, a comb, bead case, a dictionary, a dinosaur, medicine. So, you use this to wash your body. So, what is it? Okay? Now, let's show the answer. Sure. Okay, it's very good. Okay, now the questions for you now. Number one, this person looks after your teeth and helps you if you have toothache. Who is he? Who is this person? Okay, now look at this word teeth, toothache. So, when saying about this word, so who are you thinking about? Okay, of course, it's a dentist. Very good, everyone. Now let's move to the questions number two. You use this to make your hair look tidy. Okay, what do you use to make your hair look tidy? Ta-da! Yeah, it's a comb. Very good, everyone. Okay, and how about number three? You use this to stay dry when it is raining. Okay, you just need to look at the keywords here. Stay dry when it is raining. So, what is it? Yeah, one, two, three. An umbrella. Well done, my children. Very good. And now, I think it's time for you to do the rest sentences by yourself. Okay? Can you do that? Good job. Okay? Now, let's move to the next part. Part two with five questions. William is talking to his mom about going to the circus with Uncle Robert. What does William say? Read the conversation and choose the best answer. Write a letter A to H for each answer. You do not need to use all letters. Okay? Do you understand? Now, these are all the letters here from A to H you see. Now, let's read them. Number one, it started at 12 and finished at 3. B, no, thank you, I'm not hungry. C, yes, it was great. And also it is an example. Okay, D, no, we went by bus. E, I like the clouds best because they were so funny. F, yes, that's a good idea, I'll do it now. G, it was raining all morning and sunny in the afternoon. And the last one, the letter H, yes, he did, he had chocolate biscuits, I love chocolate. Okay, that's all the letter from A to H. And now the example. You see, the questions that mom asked William like this. Hello, William. Did you have fun at the circus? You see, the form here that you did, okay? Did. So, the answer must be yes or no, okay? So, the answer must be C. Yeah, it was great, okay? So, do you understand? Now, I will show you more example like this. Number one, mom asked William, which was your favorite part of the circus? You see, the word here, favorite part. So, William have to tell something about his favorite, okay, right? So, which one is suitable here? You see, the word like here, you see? I like the clouds the best because they were so funny. So I think it is suitable. So the answer must be E, right? Okay. And let's move to number two. How long did it last? Okay. It talk about the time. Okay. So just focus on the times in these letters here. Okay. And do it by yourself. Okay. Now, the same with number 3, number 4, and number 5. Look at number 3. Did you go by train? And this is also a yes no questions. And you have to use yes or no answers, okay? The same with number 4, okay? And number 5, me too. Do you want to write a thank you card for Uncle Robert? Okay? This is also a yes no questions about the giving the idea. Okay, so I bet that you can do it by yourself. Okay, now let's move to the part three with six questions. Read the story. Choose a word from the box Write the correct words next to numbers 1 to 5. That is one example. Okay. Now, first of all, look at all the words in the box here. The first thing you have to do that recognize that what kinds of word is it? Okay? Like this. Museum is a noun. Okay? Is a noun. Opened is verb. Use past simple tense, okay? Verb ed, regular verb, right? Dinosaur, also a noun. Traffic, a noun. Walking, verbing. Duck, adjectives. Show, verb. Turned, verb ed. Excited, adjective. Old, adjectives. So, the reason why you have to recognize that what kind of word is it, that it's very important that the words can put in the right place in the sentence. Okay, now I will show you one example. Last Wednesday, Michael went to the toy blah 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 with his mom. So in this position must be a noun. Okay, so we have some nouns here: museum, dinosaurs, traffic, three nouns here. So there is just only one noun that is suitable for these blanks. It must be museums. Okay, now let's move to number one. He wanted to see some blah 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 robots because robots are his favorite toy. In front of robots here, it must be an adjective. So, how many adjectives do we have here? Dark, excited, and old. So, what word is suitable here? Yeah, dark? No. Excited? No. It must be oh here. Okay. Oh, some old robots. Okay. Now, number two, when they arrived at the museum, Michael felt very. It talk about the feeling, right? And in this position, it must be an adjective. And when you talk about the feeling of the people, of someone, you have to use the word excited. Okay? It's very easy, right? And yeah, it's all robots. You have to fill in an adjective here, okay? Now, the last words. The last number. Can you do it by yourself? Okay, very good. Well done, everybody. Now, let's move to number six of this part. Now, choose the best name for the story. Tick one box. Michael's favorite toy. Uh-huh. Michael's exciting afternoon at the museum. Or Michael plays with train. Mm-hmm. So, which name is the best for the story? Okay, tell me after these lessons. Okay, now pass 4 with 10 questions. Read the text, choose the correct words, and write them on the lines. Now we have many words here. An example: camels are interesting animals, blah blah blah. Usually live in the desert. So we have 3 words: where, which, and when. So in this case, the only word that you can use is which. Okay, because animal here is talking about something, and you have to use which, not where. Okay, not when. okay, because they don't talk about the location or about time. We just talk about things, okay? Now, the question number one. This is because they blah blah needs to drink a lot and they can live without water for 2 weeks. So we have the word won't, don't, didn't. Now, look at the sentence. This is so this sentence use the simple present. So we cannot use the word didn't or won't, okay? So the only one words that suitable for this blank is don't, okay? Number two and number three. Number two, also they have fur over their ears and they can't close their noses. Blah, 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 that sand doesn't get in. Mm-hmm. So we have the word also, because, so. So which one is suitable? Okay, the same is with number three, number four, number five, number six, number seven, number eight, number nine, and number 10, okay? Do it by yourself, okay? Think carefully and fill in the blanks here with the words, okay? Now, number past five with seven questions. Look at the pictures and read the story. Write some words to complete the sentences about the story. You can use one, two, three, or four words. Yeah, this is a picture of the story. What a clever dog. This is very cute, right? Okay. Now, we start the story. Last Saturday, Harry and his sister Emma went for a walk up a mountain near their houses because it was a beautiful sunny day. They took their dog Jack with them on the way up. They sang songs together and they were very happy. Okay, and it is example. Harry and Emma have blah blah called Jack. Have what? So what are you feeling here? Have a dog, yeah, called Jack, okay? And we have questions. Number one, Harry and Emma, blah, 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 Jack's with them on their walk. So you see, here, the word they took their dog Jack with them. So you just need to fill in these blanks with one word, that is took. Okay, is this easy? Yeah, very good everyone. Now let's move to the next paragraph with the question number two. Okay, number two here. They had blah 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 for their picnic. So what did they have? Okay, oh, what did they eat for their picnic? Now you see here, they ate their picnic with world sandwiches, cake and lemonade. So what did they have? Okay, the sandwiches, cake and lemonade. Very good everyone. Okay. And number three, as they were going home, blah blah, and hurt her foot. Who? Who? Who is hurt her foot? Yeah. Now you see here, as they were walking down the mountain, Emma fell over and hurt her foot. Yeah, it's very obvious here. So, what are you feeling? Yeah, Emma fell over. Good job. Now, number four, Emma anymore. Okay, can you do it by yourself? Good job. It's very easy. And the same with number five. Okay, number six, And number seven, okay? Now, let's move to the part six with five questions. Read the email and write the missing words. Write one word on each line. Okay, it is the email that Vicky's, that George sent to Aunt Vicky. Okay? Especially in this part, you don't have any choices, don't have any available words for you to choose, but you have to think about yourself, okay? Now, the first one, I am writing to blah 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 you our exciting news. So the word tell here is the best words for you to fill in, okay? So the next, we got a new puppy yesterday. He's called Ben, blah blah blah. He's black or oral. Okay, so what words do you choose? What words do you fill in the blank? Oh, good job. It's the word N. He's called Ben and he's black or oral. And how about number two? To send you a photo of him. Go behind the word to be here. You have to fill in an adjective, right? So what adjective do you think about? Yes, okay, maybe it's happy, right? Or maybe please, okay? Do it by yourself. The same with number three, number four, and number five, okay? Now, let's move to the final part of this lesson today with only one question. Now, look at three pictures, write about this story, write 20 or more words. Okay, look at three pictures here. And I will have you to write some sentences at the beginning, okay? Now, the first one. Last Sunday, Harry went to the zoo near his house, okay? In this sentence, you can see the time, you can see the name of the character, you can see the verb, okay? You can see the location, And now, the next sentence you can use that Harry likes monkeys very much. They look so funny, okay? And he took many photos of the monkey. You see, Harry was taking some photos of the monkeys, right? Okay. And when he sat down on the bench to relax, what would happen next? Okay, can you write the sentence by yourself, okay? Okay, very good. And that's all for today, everyone. Remember to do the worksheet attached below, okay? It's time for me to say goodbye. Goodbye. Have a nice weekend, everyone. Love you.